Hello everyone. Welcome back to Family Fun with Miss Debbie. Today I'm here with my three grandchildren, TJ, Robbie, and Maya, and we are going to be making some puffy paint. Now, the recipe that I found was on a website called Meaningful Mama, and on there she had done a bunch of different puffy paint recipes, and this one she said was the best one. The only ingredients that you need flour, glue, shaving cream, make sure it's the foam and not the gel, and some poster paints, and some Ziploc bags. And we've already mixed up a couple of colors. Maya wanted to do some purple, TJ some red, and I have some white, and Robbie is going to be mixing up some green puffy paint. So I'm going to give it a little shake, and I'm going to add it, and then he is going to mix it around. And while he's mixing, I will just explain to you what we did. I mixed up the flour, the shaving cream, and the glue, and I used a half a cup of flour, a half a cup of glue, and 1.5 cups of shaving cream. We mixed that up, and then we divided it up, and we added some paint to some of the bowls. Then we keep mixing that. Rob, you're doing a good job, honey. Good job. Then we put it into the Ziploc bags, and Maya is all set to go with her purple, and she's gonna squeeze it, because one end I cut just a very small hole, just like a piping bag that you might use when you're decorating cakes or cupcakes. TJ, you can pick up your red. And do you see where I cut the little hole in the bottom? Okay. Yep. Now you could do shapes. You could do any kind of a picture or design you want. You can certainly start now. All right. And I first thought of this project when I was reading the book, It Looked Like Spilt Milk. And when I did that, I just used white, because I wanted to make clouds in the sky. And Maya looks like she is making a heart. And Robbie, how are you doing with your paint?
Good.
All right, then if you're ready, Rob, you're not ready yet?
Nope.
All right, he's going to give another mix. Now you just want to be sure that you don't mix it up too much, because you want to make sure that there are still some air bubbles left in. All right, Rob, I think that's good. We're going to run out of time and you're not going to get to start your picture. You ready?
Good.
All right, that's good. So you're going to hold open the bag, and I'm going to spoon this in so you can get started on your picture. All right, so I'm just going to spoon some in. And usually with these art projects, the messiest person turns out to be me. Is that right, guys?
Nope.
No? Is it you?
Yeah.
All right, we'll see. So we're going to zip up the bag. Let's try and squeeze that extra air. Zip it up. I'm just going to cut a very small hole in the end of the bag, and then Robbie, go for it. If you use this puffy paint recipe and want to send me any pictures, you can email me a picture of your creation to djordon, that's J-O-R-D-O-N, at mountpleasantlibrary.org. Enjoy being creative. We let our puffy paintings dry overnight. I'm not sure if you can see, however, the paint is still puffy. We used a Ziploc bag and squeezed the paint through, but you could also try using a paintbrush to create a puffy picture. Have fun!